Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, for me, let me say that I hope it's not offending for you, but it's for me, it's a kind of like a James Bond movie. Because if you're looking at the look, at the color grading, at the music, at the soundtrack, and at the end, Lisbeth Salander saves the world. So she could be maybe some kind of female Bond in some way. What did you think about that theory?
Well, I think so. I think she has a lot of elements of that. But I cannot take credit for it because that's her natural evolution she had in the books. Even by the end of the third book, she was like taking on this biker gang and fighting his own brother that couldn't sense anything, and she fight him with a nail gun. So there were a lot of elements that I think naturally came into the books that kind of inspired this more Bond-like world. But that's a really a natural progression of the books that they went from Nordic noir to pulp noir, and which is this what that's the actual same difference that this movie has with the previous movies. I mean, this really embraced that kind of pulp noir world because it's surrounded by just particularly style of filmmaking, they put you in that kind of Bond universe, right?
Mm. And she's a very strong female character. I think that's what the world needs right now. So some words about that.
Well, you know, it is, I think she's a very strong character. She happens to be a woman, but I think it's just movies have done too many times just very weak female characters. That's what Hollywood has done too many times. I mean, it's always if there's a female character at the center, usually it's a co-lead. Usually she's there to be the damsel in distress, to get kidnapped. So it was interesting here in this movie to just reverse that. And the men are way weaker than the women in this movie in general. It's all about them. And I thought it was very important for me to change things up and make it more interesting and not tell the same story that has been told a million times before, right?
Mm-hmm. And I love all these behind-the-scenes stories. Do you have maybe some nice set memories for me? Some weird days, crazy days on set?
Yeah, I mean, for sure. I mean, that's like the way I like to make films. I don't like green screens, and anything that I can do practical, I'll do practical. So that implies usually a lot of suffering for anybody involved in the movie, in the making. Because we went to all the places that you see and the adventure that you see Lisbeth going through, the crew went through, and we all went through together with the actors. So, there's a scene towards the end where they're in the cliff that we were literally there. And that means I'm with my camera right on their face, like holding the camera with a wire, hoping you're not going to fall to your death in like real places. And it's just that extreme environment where you suddenly just you go there all the way there just to get a close-up of someone to tell an emotional story. And I remember like being there like and be surprised by that it's all about that close-up of a human being that is about to have a self-revelation about themselves, and you pull back and you look at what we're doing, like what the crew is doing, where you're standing, and we are nowhere that no human being has ever gone in the most extreme circumstances, and just to tell a story. And for me, I mean, I remember that day, like it touched me personally because it's unbelievable, like what film does to go and tell a personal story, how the big things we do just to do something that we all believe is very important, to keep telling human stories and try to find what is the thing that unites us all and connects us and what's the thing that we have in common as human beings. So that really was that combination of pain but reward is something that I take away from this movie.
And you shot also in Berlin, not only in Babelsberg.
Yeah.
I recognize the Behrens Street. Was it that?
Was
Behrensstraße,
that street?
Where Lisbeth Salander came out with a motorcycle at the beginning of the movie, between Hotel de Rome and Hotel
Oh, yeah. No, but that's Stockholm, no? When she comes out of the building,
okay.
That's Stockholm.
Because it looks exactly like Berlin.
Yeah,
do you have maybe some outside locations in Berlin?
Yes, we had most of it that we did in Berlin was in Babelsberg, indoors. We had that NSA tower that we did some of that, in that tower where she goes with the car. I'm sure you recognize that. And then a lot of the snow, but that was like West Germany. A lot of the snow at the end because we were chasing the snow. There was no snow close to Stockholm at that time. But then street-wise and stuff like that, most of it. I think there's some exterior ones of Plague's apartment that I think was the streets in here.
Okay, thank you so much for taking the time.
Thank you so much.
All the best
for coming
out of the movie.
Thank you so much.